I've got all this walnut and been sitting here for like a year, and I really need to cut it into cookies so it can dry. It's pretty heavy. I think I'm gonna do 3-inch slabs on this. So this cut looks pretty concentric, so I think I'm just gonna start there and work my way down. So let's flip this thing over. Quick tip when setting your mill height, set up a 1/2-inch impact on your drill. You can easily lower and raise the height. Hey, what's up? What's that?
Last night's day to work outside.
You think? Is it gonna get worse? Yeah.
Now this one's pretty big, as you can see, that's a 36 inch blade. Probably 30 inches by 4 feet. And it's a good foot deep. Here's all the other ones. So I'm gonna try just going straight across it. And then we'll go through that stack, which is like oak and walnut. Make some smaller cookies. Blade's starting to go on this walnut, so hopefully I can make it through this stack before having to sharpen. Can you smell the walnut in the morning? Look at all those cookies. Probably, let's see, 6, 7, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 cookies. These are my biggest ones. Oh yeah. This thing is a gas hog. Fill it up like every other cut. Cut my hand. Wear gloves, kids.
that was the last of it. That last bit was oak that was in my yard when I bought the house. And it's dried from the inside out, you can see. Which is interesting, I think. So, that is a lot of cookies. I don't know what this is. I'm gonna seal both ends of these because they're end grain. That'll hopefully make them dry a little bit slower and not split, so.